Hi, today we are going to discuss how to write and execute program. It is a 8086 assembly program using TASM software. So before going to execute and write and execute the program, first of all you have to download the compatible OS compatible TASM software from the internet. You have to double click on this software so that the window, the command window will show by double clicking on the software. Like now look at here, in this you can open the TASM software which is required to write and execute the program. So this is the command window. So first of all you have to write the program using the command called as the edit. So it will give goes into the written mode. Edit, you have to give the name of the program and the extension, that is the file name. I'm giving here add, and extension is ASM. Enter it. So I already written the program here. So I will tell you what is the these different sections. So this is the actually basically the data segment section, and this is the code segment section. So there are the two different models. One is called as the dot model and another is called as the assumption model. So this whatever the program written here, it is using the dot model. So always you have to specify whenever you write the assembly level program what kind of model you are used, either small or large models. After that you have to write down the from where you can access the numbers or from which location you want to store the numbers. So these are the variables I am assigning, right? These A and B, two 16 bit numbers, and these two locations I am using to store the result. So these variables location is available in anywhere, it is in memory. So this is the code segment. So here we can write the code, and finally this is the end of the program. We will discuss later about the program. Just I am showing the how to write the program and execute it. So after writing the program you have to save it and exit. So again it goes to the back to the command window. So here you have to follow the steps to execute the program. First of all you have to compile it. So to compile this you have the command called as the TASM and the name of the file, that is add.asm. So this is the compilation. So if there is an error then it will show the error here, that is a message error. Otherwise there is a no error. So it is the pass one. Then another part is the performing the linking. To perform the linking you have to write down the tlink and file name. You can write the obj also. So it is a linking is done. Now final step is to execute it. There is a td and file name. So this is the execution of the program. So this is actually your original program, right? But here instead of the variable, whatever you assign the variables previously, so here variables are not shown. Instead of the memory locations are shown in the program. I have written that is a transfer the contents of variable A to X. But here is not showing the variable A. Instead of it will show the memory location where the variable A is access from the memory. So that is a 00E is the memory location, then B 0010, like this. So finally your result is stored in this place, that is a 0012 and 0010. So to execute the program, you have to execute the program not in whole at a time. Instead of that, you have to execute in step by step. So for that we are use the F7 key. So if you use the F7 key, simultaneously you can observe the contents of modifying contents of the register, general purpose register. Now you can check 8AC5A, this value is assigned for the variable A. Now it is available in AX, similarly BX. You have to execute the program till interrupt, and now you have to observe the all the contents, that is a memory location contents, that is a variable assigned the variable as well as the result. You have to go to the view and dump. So in this dump option you can observe the all things, that is from what location you are taking the number 00E. This is 0, this is 8, right? This is the 9, this is the 10, A, B, C, D, and this is the E. So actually the F and E contain the first number, that is a 8AC5. This is actually our first number, right? That is a which is available or assigned to the variable A. Then at 10, this is 10. 10 and 11 contain our another number, that is 90. You can see 10, 90C2. This is your another number. So where your result is stored? In the 12. This is our result. 28. After adding these two numbers, 2887. And there is a carry. That's why carry is stored in another place. So you can observe the result also. This is the actually I want to tell you with this video, that is how to write the program, how to execute, and how to observe the result in the memory location. Same time you can observe the different flags, the status of the different flag. Now here carry generated, that's why carry flag is shown as a 1. Remaining flag there is a no change. Okay, so after completion of this one, if you want to exit from this one, you have to quit it. And finally, if you have to exit from this command window, you have to write down the exit. So if you write the exit, it will come out from the window.